Welcome to this very special press brief from Cross River State, All Progressives Congress, which is in response to the decision of the Forum of APC State Chairmen in Nigeria, occasioned by the threat to our democratic order and ideals in respect of the state of the nation. As you are all aware, after a series of engagements by the Forum of All APC State Chairmen in Nigeria, from last week that culminated in a meeting with the National Working Committee on Friday last week, 26th day of July, and after explaining the situation in the country and agreeing totally that a bold and very courageous but very difficult decisions that Mr. President took on the 29th day of May 2023, though very wonderful, but the reality is that it has brought some difficulties. It has brought some hardship. It has brought some pains. And even as we gather as Nigerians and Crossriverians to commend Mr. President for those bold initiatives, which primarily were to reset the economy of this country, because it became very clear that without those decisions, the payment of fuel subsidy that was before now put at 40 million to 15 million consumption per day, liters per day, but which today has dropped to about 16 to 20 million, which we don't know whether all the vehicles that were paying subsidy for then had disappeared to thin air. But because of these courageous and bold moves, the payment of those subsidies is gone. And Nigeria today has more revenue. Revenue today that accounts for payment of salaries without us doing ways and means again. In ordinary grammar, ways and means means printing of money. You are all aware that Zimbabwe dollar went to its low because they were doing ways and means. Idi Amin in his days in Uganda was practicing ways and means. Unfortunately, that was the direction which the federal government of Nigeria, before May 29th, 2023, had incurred on. That direction was not good for us. So today we commend Mr. President for taking those bold initiatives that has put an end to payment of fuel subsidy and subsidy for foreign exchange. For those of you who have been following the economy of Nigeria, up until May 29th, you could just do what is called round tripping. You go to CBN if you have the contacts within, without, and the political runabout. You will buy dollars for about 400 and something naira, and immediately proceed to sell for 750 and above. You become an overnight millionaire and billionaire. But that is the pains we have got to live with today, that we have come face to face with reality. Those are the eras of economic phantasmagorias. They do not exist any longer. And we can only commend Mr. President for that. But it comes with a very great price. The price for that is why today the cost of living have gone so high. That is why today prices of food are beyond the reach of an average Nigerian. That is why food inflation and everything has skyrocketed. That is why Naira has bowed down to the supremacy of the dollar. However, it is time again to have a reassessment of what Mr. President has done in the face of all this, and what our dear governor, particularly in Cross River State, have done. It is therefore on account of this that we have invited you today to let you know that while protest is a constitutional right of Nigerians guaranteed under Section 38, 39, 40 of our Constitution to associate, to assemble. Section 45, however, gives an exception that if that will threaten public order and public peace, it can be curtailed. Today, the government of Nigeria, through the Inspector General of Police, have agreed to provide security to protect protesters. However, as a government and a party that worked so hard to put this government in place, and that have promised Nigerians renewed hope, we are appealing again. We have been appealing and will continue to appeal that now that we have heard your voices, now that we share in your pains, because we are not insulated from the hardship in the land, we also feel your pains. But with the security reports that we have heard, it will not be too good. The political undercurrent proceeds to the direction of the calamity that befell us 4 years ago in the name of ENDSARS. Will it therefore not be better for us to continue to dialogue so that you will see the plans being made by Mr. President? You will assess the palliative being done by Mr. President, and you can as well give your advice so that this whole point can be treated like a family matter. Because to go to the street, and if only one solar bulb that Governor Otu have put in the street of Calabar is destroyed, the money we will use to extend these solar bulbs to other areas will now be needed to replace this. And for a governor in particular in Cross River State that only recently brought 10 billion to cater for the gratuity of our own 8 parents that retired and have not been catered for. For a governor that has brought sweetness truly by paying school fees of everybody that registered for WAEC, including their WAEC registration, today that has enabled your children to get their refunds of whatever you expended. And for a government that has changed the landscape of Cross River State, carrying roads, providing social amenities, having streetlights across everywhere, and granting appointments and opening the vistas for employment opportunities for Cross Riverians, and doing those things that hitherto were not done. Is it not only good for us to commend him by applauding him and encouraging him to do more instead of going to the streets? Is it not time for us as Nigerians to look at the president's policy, the renewed hope programs, starting with the student's loan scheme, the consumer credit, the intervention in agriculture through tractorization and through mechanization and through land clearing provision, to providing of seeds and seedlings, fertilizers, all free of charge, just to address the issue of hunger? For the man who has boldly come up to say no, the persistent issue of farmers' herders is one of the things that have been responsible for hunger in the land, because people cannot go to farm. Therefore, let us have a ministry of livestock so that herders can be confined to a particular area and not graze on farmers' land, so that government can now make necessary provision. For a government that has come to fight corruption, and today, from just 800,000 barrels per day before he took over the government of the Federal Republic, it is today 1,600,000 barrels per day. Dear brothers and sisters, and so many, many other things that he has done, fighting insurgency and banditry, giving opportunity for the Northwest Development Commission, for the Southeast Development Commission, and so many other commissions that will still come to address the needs of our people. And today has awarded wages, of which the minimum is at 70,000 naira. Therefore, for the first time in the history of Nigeria, we have an increment of about 133.3% from 30,000 to 70,000. is a man like this not supposed to be commended? Today, Nigeria is set on a voyage to have a workable refinery. We have been voting money during the Sani Abacha's period for turnaround maintenance from that period of 1993 till recently. But for the first time, Port Harcourt Refinery is set to start refining crude for petrol consumption in Nigeria. Secondly, Dangote Refinery has just been given a lifeline, an initiative where he himself, as then governor of Lagos, gave land to Dangote to come and establish a refinery. That refinery today is ready to run. And for those of you who have been following the trajectory in the last few months, diesel went to about 1,600 and something naira. Today with the Dangote refinery, diesel has come down to about 1,000 and it will continue to go down. And the federal government is not resting on its hours. Today, the compressed natural gas conversion vehicle kits are everywhere and we are set to even have the price of fuel fall down, because from the 16 million to about 20 million consumption, with 1 million cars set to be converted from the present 18 point something million vehicles, 8 point something million vehicles that we have in Nigeria, it is possible that consumption would drop to around 10 million for fuel, and every other person might go through the CNG that will just be selling for 200 naira. Please, our dear people, our appeal has been, our president needs more time. And we use this forum to say we want to appeal to Nigerians to please, for the sake of God, for the sake of nationhood, for the sake of Cross River State, and for the sweetness in the land, let us not go to the streets. As a party, we have taken this measure that we shall solidarize with our governor as a way of encouraging him to do more. We shall do solidarity with Mr. President for all the wonderful things he has done, which I have just rolled out, and the many that will use the opportunity of this solidarity rally to roll out to our people to know. And in doing so, we have complied with the order of the federal government through the IG that anybody who wants to be on the street from tomorrow must do so by getting a permit to do so. APC Cross River State, in conjunction with Rightly Guided Thinking Crossriverians across party lines, have written to the Commissioner of Police for permit to also be in our office, to be on the streets, and our routes will be a commencement point from this party office through the 12-kilometer carnival route. Our point of harbor will be the 1111 square. We will also intermittently spend time at Rabana. We will also have time at Efiete Junction. So these are the routes we have secured. And up till this moment, to our knowledge, it is only APC Cross River State that have secured a rally from now till 11th of August to use this route. From what we have gathered, the only available route for anybody that wants to foment trouble will be around Odupani Junction heading towards Itu Headbridge. Therefore, as journalists, please take note that we are not looking for trouble. We will only be on the street to sing praises and to thank God Almighty for giving us the duo of President Asiwaju Bola Ahmed Tinubu and the sweet prince that has brought sweetness to the land. And at the end of it, we'll be having a series of engagements. These engagements from the second will be with youths and students to roll out the achievement of our dear president and governor. After them, we'll be engaging the religious groups. We'll be meeting with support groups and the IPAC. We'll be meeting with farmers. We'll be meeting with civil servants. We'll be meeting with NURT, National Union of Road Transport Workers, Road Transport Owners, Keke Riders, and the Okada Riders, down to independent marketers, and the various religious groups, all in the name of telling them this is what we have done. The market women will not be left out. And so the organized labor too, that we have recently awarded wages that is in humongous capacity and form, will all be made to know that this is what we'll also do about their wages in the next 2 or 3 years. We shall no longer wait for 5 years for wage review. It is in the light of this that we have gathered you to let you know on this. And our line of our activities, which we shall hand over to you are all contained here. I shall hand them over to the NUJ chair. You will see what we will start out to do. For us, we will only be on the streets, so that if people gather and want to do trouble, we will report them to the security agencies. We have had stakeholders' engagement since morning till this hour for us to collectively protect the democracy, which most of you worked so hard with your sweat, which some of you lost your members to protect. We have left Egypt. Never again shall we return to those Neolithic era to give room for political chicanerous persons to come and lobotomize what we have collectively developed. As a party, we are aware that some people say they want to protest. We have appealed to them, don't protest. But they say they will protest. And all we are saying, if you want to protest, the Inspector General of Police have said anybody that wants to do anything rally to come and get permit. So you know that if we don't also apply within this period to try to correct the erroneous messages on social media and in the streets, people will think that what they are saying is the truth. Because a lie that is further embellished can sometimes be believed by some ignorant person, saying that there is good governance in Cross River State. We are also saying that there is good governance in Nigeria, despite the hardship we are going through. That Mr. President never promised that when he was taking those difficult decisions, that there was not going to be hardship and pains. He said it was going to be, but it was going to be ephemeral. And that within those period, there will be palliatives. And he has been cushioning the hardship with palliatives. There is virtually no house, including all of you sitting here as journalists. If you have not been reached, Mr. President sent 20 trucks of rice to us with beans, with Gary. Our governor has bought more. If it has not gotten to you, it has not passed you, we will bring. It is to cushion this hardship within this period. The wage has been given and people need to know. Now the borders have been open for food to come in. The import taxes on pharmaceutical drugs and on imported goods have all been waived for 6 months. It means even this bag of rice we are talking about will crash to around 20 or 25,000 by December. Because once the harvest comes, I am a farmer myself, you all know. I am one of the highest herders. I keep cows, native and Hausa cows. So I know what the seasons are. And I farm yam, I do rice, I do yellow pepper. And I'm delving into yellow maize and soybeans. But the climate change this year, during March and April, the sun came and killed almost everything we planted around that period. It is only what we planted in June now that we are about to harvest from August. Yala people and almost every community that farm yam and cassava will start harvest from this August. You all know. So prices of yam will go down. Garri is already going down. Rice has now been subsidized to 40,000. And we are saying that these narratives we have done to respond to hunger, people should know. But because we have become aware that some people want to topple our government, we have declared that we cannot fold our arms. It's only a tree that is standing, that you go and put a jigsaw and you are cutting and it will not react. It is an utmost obvious threat to our government. And you can confirm this from the Charter of Demands by the protesters. And number one is that the Constitution of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, which our president swore to protect and to defend, they say it should be jettisoned. But they have forgotten that that is the Constitution that they said they have derived their powers to protest. Thank God for the speech of the governor yesterday. He's doing his best. He will do more. And he has appealed to people not to protest. But for those that will not heed to this advice, the governor has said a special place for them, called Afukam, will be reserved for them if they intend to go violent. But we as a party, we have added, because the governor recently did something that is very wonderful in Cross River State. He went and established a lunatic asylum in Calabar South. The mad people are already there. If you're on the street tomorrow against all this advice, and you do it peacefully, we don't have any problem. But if you decide to go violent, will only report you to the security agents. And they will take you to that lunatic asylum. So that you and your colleagues who are madmen will stay there to see how you can run your affairs. Cross River State is not a safe haven for any violent protest. Because what they destroyed 4 years ago, we have not been able to recover.